Welcome back. Well, no real change for the Nifty. So we are currently still at 7436. We still have quite a dismal advance decline ratio on our hands, which stands at around 1:2. But do watch out for some incremental buying coming in on the likes of HCL Tech. So that stock has recovered a little bit. The intraday chart should tell you more. And similar case with something like an Infosys also. So Infosys is seeing some amount of recovery in the past hour of trade. And that stock too has seen some amount of incremental buying. In fact, at the high point of the day for Infosys as we speak. But we have some commodity strategies lined up now. Hitesh Jain of IIFL joins in for that. Hitesh, hi, thanks very much for taking the time out. First, what would your strategy be on gold, considering that it is ahead of the Fed Reserve commentary as well?
Most of the market participants will prefer to remain on the sidelines ahead of the meet. But although Fed is not expected to make a move this month, but the perception of relatively hawkishness when you compare with other central banks will keep the bulls on the defensive. See, although we have a very positive outlook on the precious metal and on the broader horizon, where we're expecting gold to hit $1,380 or $1,400 per ounce before the end of June. But before that happens, we expect some retracement in gold and silver prices. So we do not rule out a retest of low of $1,180 to $1,200 within the next few weeks, before the resumption of the broader trend. So for today, we prefer to sell gold and silver both. I think gold we prefer to sell on the M6 at 29,200. The target for the intraday or the short-term perspective should be 28,800, 28,900. And stop loss should be kept around 29,380 for gold.
Okay. Hitesh, hi. Good morning. What about crude? How would you approach it?
See, the recent trajectory in oil prices is more influenced by the optics rather than what's happening on the ground reality. Now it's currently producing around 2.8, that is literally 1.2 billion barrel per more than the current levels. So I think it's confined into a kind of a broad range where we see 35 as a bottom as WTI is concerned, for 39 as a resistance as far as WTI is concerned. So we'll prefer to the swing strategy where we'll buy around the bottom and sell around the resistance. So for today, I think we'll still take a chance where the perception of some kind of price stabilization by the oil producing nations is in the offing. So we prefer to buy around 2450. The MCX target should be around 250 and stop loss should be around 2400.
Okay. How about copper?
See, we saw a healthy rally in most of the non-ferrous metals in the past few weeks, and some kind of profit taking is inevitable. And moreover, the recent flow of numbers from China has not been positive. Look at industrial production or the retail sales number. Although expectation of some stimulus from the Chinese central bank is providing some support, but we expect some retracement in the entire non-ferrous spec. So but today, we prefer to sell copper. We're seeing that copper is failing to breach the resistance of 340 on the MCX. We'll prefer to sell at the current levels, probably at 336, 337, and the target should be 330, and stop loss should be around 340.
All right, Hitesh, thanks a lot for those trading ideas. So that's some commodity ideas. By the way, there's in terms of individual names, there are a couple of stocks which are moving now. Alok Industries.